Bill Maher, Don T. Lump Al Franken with Weinstein, Spacey and Donald Trump. Bill Maher didn't exactly go easy on his pal Al Franken tonight, spending much of the opening monologue and a big chunk of real-time as season finale tossing joke grenades at the Minnesota senator. But the HBO host drew a hard line between the former Saturday Night Live staffer and the ever-growing gang of famous abusers and grabbers. Maher then described the scandal, the photo of Franken mock gropingly in tweeting, then writing and demanding a rehearsal of a sketch calling for a kiss. Alice a friend, Maher said, but L.A. gotta tell you, if you write the comedy sketch where you, Al Franken, kiss a model and the next line of dialogue isn't he get off of me, creepy, it's not comedy, it's science fiction. Jokes out of the way, Maher got to his point, he did a bad thing and the condemnation has been universal, which he deserves. What he deserves is to be lumped in with Roy Moore. Or Kevin Spacey. Or Harvey Weinstein. Or Donald Trump, who calls his accusers liars, threatens to sue them, did long riffs at his rallies where he said they were too ugly for him to assault. Plus, with Al Franken we re talking about one incident. Trump has 16 accusers. Roy Moore has 9. Roy Moore spent more time chatting up young girls at the mall than Santa Claus. Franken came up again later in the show when comedian and activist Chelsea Handler joined the panel and noted that Franken, facing one allegation, took responsibility, while Trump pretends he is going to sue his accusers. I agree with you on Al Franken, Handler said. I am sorry, he is not a predator. Everybody who has met him knows that is not true. He made a mistake. He is not a predator. Maher then challenged this afternoon as cable news wisdom that Franken should resign, decrying a culture that don't you know the difference between zero tolerance and maximum punishment. At which point panelist Rebecca Traister, a writer for New York Magazine and author of All the Single Ladies, took the mic, metaphorically speaking, and dropped it, all in one long, breath-free and beautifully worded speech. Carl Bernstein, environmental activist Bill McKibben and author Max Brooks were also on the show, but Traister deserves all of the last words here, to focus on what the punishment is going to be, she said about the harassers, is on some level an easier conversation to have, because then we get to fight about it. Should he resign? And then we get to go to our partisan battle stations. That is easier than actually looking at the more difficult conversation, which is about the whole culture, a culture that empowers white men to abuse their power in a million ways, from the villainous predator.